Today is a very exciting day because some genius overclockers have figured out how to take this pedestrian RX 9070 and flash a 9070 XT BIOS onto it, turning it into a fire-breathing dragon of a card. And today, I'm gonna give that a try. But before we get into that, today's video is sponsored by Micro Center. Check out their April Apple sales event if you want to get in on some Apple Silicon action at a great price. Micro Center is also inching ever closer to their new Santa Clara location. Sign up down below and receive a free 128GB flash drive when the store opens later this year. And while you're there, you may as well check out Micro Center's new GPU trade-in program and their tech recycling. Links for everything, including Micro Center news, down below. Now, straight off the bat, I don't know if this is the kind of thing that works with specific versions of the cards and not with others, and unfortunately, I've just got this Asus Prime 9070 to test it on, so if it works with this, it may work with other ones. Now, aside from that, there are some important things to note. The 9070 XT has 64 compute units, where the normal 9070 just has 56, and unfortunately, flashing the new BIOS onto the 9070 doesn't unlock those extra 8 CUs. But what it does do is it unlocks the TDP of the card. The 9070 tends to draw about 230 watts, whereas a 9070 XT draws over 300, and pumping all of that extra power into the 9070 should give us a healthy boost in core frequencies and in performance. So I'm curious to see how much we're gonna step up in those two categories with this BIOS flash. Now, one of the features on this Asus Prime 9070 that I have here actually fills me with quite a lot of confidence around doing this process, because BIOS flashing is quite a dark art and I'm scared of screwing it up, because if something can go wrong, it will with me. So luckily, this Prime card does have two BIOS chips. There's a little switch on it where you can switch between them, which is super useful, because if I screw up flashing the BIOS, I'm not gonna brick this fancy graphics card. Because it also means that I can switch back to the 9070 BIOS if I need to. Now, you may think, if you've got a bunch more performance and the BIOS doesn't botch, why would you want to go back? Well, apparently this new BIOS does turn off some features on the 9070, like its ultra-low power mode. So if, for example, you want to play a game that doesn't need all of the extra performance, but you want to reduce the amount of heat and energy that this card is dumping into your room, you can switch back to the normal 9070 BIOS. I think that's pretty cool. So hopefully I don't screw this up. But with that, before we do the BIOS flash, let's see how this 9070 behaves with the stock BIOS, or at least the performance BIOS, on this Prime card, and then we'll take it from there. Now, this is Cyberpunk running at 1440p ultra settings, and straight out of the box in its default configuration with the performance BIOS, we're sitting at about 230 watts of power draw. In fact, it's very consistently there. And with that power draw, we're getting about 2.6 gigahertz of core frequency. It does fluctuate quite a bit from there, but 2.6-ish is the range we're looking at, which gives us quite a lot of performance. We've got about 100 frames per second going here. But with that, let's try and flash a new BIOS onto it. Now, the first thing that I'm gonna do is turn the system off and switch to the quiet BIOS, because I wanna keep the performance BIOS on the system and then just reflash the quiet one. Now, my first attempt was to do a software BIOS flash using AMD VB flash. This was despite the fact that there wasn't listed support for the new AMD cards, but I wanted to try it anyway.
A few moments later.
Okay, so I've been poking around and it seems like this software AMD BIOS flasher doesn't support these cards yet. I tried and the software just doesn't want to launch at all, which means I'm probably gonna have to use like a BIOS flasher to just, this is getting scarier already. I don't know, the moment that an external BIOS flasher gets involved, things get scary. But you know, if like professional overclockers, people who, you know, actually know what they're doing can do this, surely some random idiot on the internet can also do it. So we just lift this off and pray that we've got some BIOS chip action on the back here. No, it's not on the back. But once I was halfway through removing the rest of the cooler, I spotted something. Oh, no, 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 there they are, there they are. Oh my God. Thank God I spotted that now, because if I took the whole cooler off and then realized that they were just sitting here, that would have been crazy. These, I'm pretty sure, are the BIOS chips. It's usually indicated with the white dot, which is there. And they are very much BIOS chip shaped. So do I assume that like when the switch is left, it's the left chip. And then honestly, it doesn't really matter because from what I could tell, the two BIOSes perform basically the same.
Now, using one of these CH341A BIOS flashers is a dark art on the same level as voodoo. I have never had this not be a disaster, and today was no different. The problem started immediately when I couldn't for the life of me identify what this BIOS chip was. When I googled the markings, I just got a bunch of random Japanese websites, and Google Lens just spat out a bunch of generic pictures of other BIOS chips. Eventually, I just gave up and hoped that it didn't matter. But then, I couldn't get the BIOS programming software to get any reading off the chip, which in retrospect is quite normal. Getting that clip to properly attach takes dozens of attempts, like a virgin looking for a G-spot, and like said virgin, I was immediately spooked. And this second failure convinced me that maybe these aren't the BIOS chips. So I took off the cooler and had a look at the other side of the PCB, where there was nothing BIOS chip shaped at all. Panic growing, I then decided to try the software route again, except this time actually follow instructions, where I eventually got confirmation through the command prompt from the software itself that it doesn't support these cards. So I had no choice but to get back to my inept fumbling around the graphics card's nether regions. I then tried looking for the BIOS chip again using the full company name, GigaDevice, as opposed to the abbreviation, and that combined with using some different numbering on the chip actually got me some useful information. Firstly, it was a 1.8 volt BIOS chip, which this CH341A doesn't natively support. Luckily, I have a little 1.8 volt adapter, and with that change and some more persistent clipping attempts, I finally got NeoProgrammer to read the BIOS chip. But then I immediately ran into the problem where NeoProgrammer couldn't read the BIOS that I had downloaded from Tech PowerUp's website. That file was a .rom, and NeoProgrammer only reads .bin for some reason. I then spent over an hour trying to figure this out, because the BIOS programmers that could read the .rom file couldn't find the BIOS chip for some reason, and I just couldn't find a way to convert the files because apparently no one else has ever had this problem. But then, eventually, somewhere in the depths of the internet, I found a post where someone said you can just change the file name from .rom to .bin, which sounds completely absurd, but it actually worked. Which meant I was finally in the position where I could read the BIOS chip, and I had a file that I could install on it. Unfortunately, after writing it, I did get a small error. But this was by far the closest I've been, so I decided to try the card out.
Did I brick the card?
As you can tell by my wild stank face, I wasn't getting a signal out. So I decided to try the other BIOS, which did give me a signal out, which meant progress.
Okay, so the fact that I've broken the BIOS on it means we're making progress, right? Because things happened. So now I just need to properly write a BIOS onto it.
I then reattached the BIOS writer, real good this time. And for some reason, this time when writing the new BIOS onto it, I didn't get any error warnings. Unfortunately, the first boot attempt didn't work, which really hit me in the mentals.
The fact that it doesn't work after that flash makes me think that it's not gonna work. But yeah, I didn't get any like failed BIOS flashing warnings.
But then I decided to try one more time.
Oh! It's the correct... Oh! No way. Oh, it's even doing...
The driver is still needing to identify the graphics card is what I meant to say. But unfortunately, despite that success, GPU Z gave some bad news.
It still says 9070 though.
But I still decided to launch a game just to see what the power draw was doing.
Oh, it worked! Look! I am just a genius. That's the only way to put it. It's worked. Oh, I am so excited. Look, it's 320 watts going to the card. With the other BIOS, you can't get it to draw more than about 230 because nothing that you do to the power draw targets affects it. But here, that is, it's kind of all over the place, but it peaks at 310 and the core frequency is higher. Oh, that's so exciting. Well, actually, on this note, I need to drop it in the other system, because this isn't the system that I tested it in the first time. But that it worked.
And once I moved it back to the initial system, the performance gains were impressive.
Oh, look at that, 320 watts. Whoa, and it's, I think the frame rate is a solid amount higher. Whoa.
The card jumped from an average of 118 to an average of 148 with the XT BIOS.
Oh yeah, look at that, 140 frames per second, well over 300 watts utilized. Now in terms of core frequency, it's interesting because it's sitting at about 3 gigahertz, which with undervolting on the stock BIOS, I've been able to get that core frequency even higher than that. So I am curious to see what undervolting with this BIOS is gonna do.
Just a quick note, 9070 overclocking is really weird. The max frequency offset slider does nothing for some reason, but when you drop the voltage offset, it increases the core frequency.
So here, right, we're looking for voltage offset. I'm gonna drop this to minus 100, which it would happily do with the stock BIOS. Hey, there we go. There's a jump in core frequency with slightly lower power draw, I think.
Which did give us a bit of a jump in average frame rate at the cost of some 1% lows. I then pushed the voltage to minus 150, which finished a run, but instability was starting to creep in. And anything above that would crash. And with that, we've successfully flashed a 9070 XT BIOS onto a 9070 with some big performance gains. Also, if you try this at home and break your graphics card, it's not my fault. Which brings me to the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed it. And until the next video, bye-bye.